Hi, sorry everybody. Sorry I haven't been making videos in quite a while, but I've been dealing with a pretty serious health issue. 2 months ago, I was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. Now, diabetes runs in the family, and it's just my time to have it. But I'm doing all right. I'm managing my diet, I'm dropping weight, but it does occupy a lot of my time. I have to exercise a lot more than I already have been. Over the past 5 years, I've dropped 50 pounds, according to my doctor, I need to drop another 50. And since my diagnosis 2 months ago, I dropped 10. So I'm on the way. I find that I'm having to shop a lot for nutritious food and foods that won't spike my sugar levels. And I'm also doing a lot of my own cooking now, so that's eating out is very difficult for me to do. But let me show you what my morning routine is. This is something that I have to do probably for the rest of my life.
This is part of my morning ritual. The contents of this little bag contains prep swabs, a glucose meter, lancets, a lancing device, and testing strips. And here I am laying out all the testing supplies on top of my monthly worksheet that I use to record my daily results. And now that I'm diabetic, it's important for me to monitor my blood glucose level. So every morning I record what's called the fasting level. Basically, this tells me how much glycogen my liver has produced overnight and gives me an idea of how much I should or shouldn't eat for breakfast. And over the course of the day, I usually will test my blood 4 to 5 times, and if I'm ill, I'm supposed to test every 4 hours. Here I am warming up my hand, trying to increase blood flow to my finger. And there I'm inserting the test strip into the glucose meter. And now I'm lancing my finger with the lancing device. I have a pretty thick skin, so sometimes I have to squeeze pretty hard just to convince some blood to come out. And there I am applying a drop of blood to the test strip. And here's a trick I learned in my diabetic education class, and that's don't take the swab out of the packet. Just insert your finger inside the packet and sterilize your finger there. That way when you throw it away, you don't have two things to toss, you only have one. And there I just recorded my glucose level, and inside the meter there's a menu in there where I can make notations as to if it was before meal or before meal or after meal reading. And that red container you see there, that's what's called a Sharps disposal container. And anything that I produce during my testing that has blood on it goes in there. In the state of California, it's illegal to dispose of needles and other Sharps materials in the public sanitation system. So when that gets full, I take it to the hospital and they will dispose of it for me along with the rest of their biohazardous material. In addition to testing my blood, I'm also taking medications to help support my pancreas, liver, kidneys, and I'm also dealing with some high cholesterol. I also received a vaccine to guard against pneumonia. But that's pretty much what I do every morning. I take medications, I test my blood, and then I go out and have breakfast. And 138, that's not a bad fasting number.